And before doing so, I'll just read the motion into the record, Deputy, please. Okay. The following motion was received from Deputy Boyd Barrett, that the Joint Committee on Finance, Public Expenditure Reform, Subcommittee on Global Corporate and Multi-Taxation Architecture shall, as part of its terms of reference, invite into the committee to give testimony and answer questions representatives of multinational corporations based here in Ireland, including representatives of Apple. Seconder now. Google, Facebook and other such corporations as the subcommittee may deem appropriate. Deputy Boyd Barrett to speak to your motion.
Thanks, Chair. Chair, you said that we shouldn't be forced into bringing in the multinationals. In comments in the earlier discussion. You made reference to a crisis.
This is the third time.
I'm the only person you interrupt.
Because you've been incorrect three times this afternoon, Deputy. You're now reading comments from me into the record that were not actually made. So please be measured in your comments.
Okay. We are facing a crisis in this country.
You said about me earlier, yes? Are you withdrawing the comment on that?
Withdrawing what comment?
That you put out something that I made a suggestion earlier, which I didn't. So are you correct or are you incorrect?
You did make a statement earlier on.
Yes.
Relating to the issue of inviting multinationals in a crisis situation. I can't remember the exact wording.
Well, if you can't remember, please don't quote me.
Sorry. I paraphrased you.
No, you didn't. You were actually incorrect.
Paraphrasing. Yeah.
You were incorrect. So
I did, and we can read back the record and look at what you said.
Yes, you can. I can tell you what I actually said.
Well, tell me what you said.
I said this committee will not be crisis-driven.
Right. Well, that's exactly the comment.
Well, it is not.
So, and that was in the context of a discussion about whether we should bring the multinationals in. So I think we should be crisis-driven because our public finances are in a crisis, in the most severe crisis that they have ever faced. And that seems to me, that crisis faced by our public finances is precisely why we need to have the multinationals that have been accused internationally of engaging in aggressive tax avoidance in before this committee to answer questions about that. We owe it to the citizens of this country who are being crucified with unjust and unfair austerity measures, taxes, things they can't pay and can't afford, to bring in super profitable, super wealthy multinationals that there are very serious allegations being made against about their failure to pay their fair share in taxation. We owe it to the people of this country. And I have to comment on the unprecedented mobilisation of the political establishment in this country, reflected in this committee today, where Fine Gael, Labour and Fianna Fáil and some independents have banded together to protect the multinationals in this country from even being asked questions about their tax affairs. It's simply extraordinary. Can we not at least explore it? And the idea that we would look into global multinational tax architecture and how it relates to this country without inviting in the key subjects of that discussion, the multinationals themselves, to ask them questions about their tax affairs, just beggars belief. It does make a farce of this committee, and I think would outrage the people of this country if they find out about it, that we couldn't even ask them those simple questions. And, you know, there's over recent times, there's been much talk about groupthink and how groupthink led us to the disastrous situation that we are in now. Well, I have never seen a more profound example of groupthink where you're not allowed to question the consensus than what we are seeing around the issue of corporate tax and the multinationals. You can't even ask the questions, never mind change the policy. It is just beyond belief. And all we are asking is that they should be part of this investigation. That's all we're asking. But it is absolutely clear that the amender of Deputy Doherty's motion and those who are almost certainly going to vote against this motion now simply do not want the multinationals brought in here. And if Deputy Donnelly was right in saying that it was always envisaged. What is the problem with my motion saying that it will be part of the remit of the committee? That's all it's saying. It's not saying in what order. It is simply saying that it will be part of a remit of a committee looking into multinational taxation and its relationship to this country, that at some point we will ask those people in. That's all it's saying. We can do it at the end of the phase or at whatever point we consider acceptable. But what those who are opposing these motions are doing is really trying to prevent it. And that is quite shameful. It's a conspiracy of silence. It's a cover-up of an issue of immense importance. And what's at stake here is, I mean, some estimates say there's 18 trillion euro of these profits floating around the world at the moment. Even a small fraction of that going back into the revenues of states, cash-starved states like ours, the United States, Britain, Europe, desperately in need of funds and finances to re-kickstart the economy, and the fact that we can't even talk about it. We can't ask these guys questions. We're shivering with fear in the face of the multinationals, so much so that we can't even bring them in to ask questions. It just beggars belief. So I intend to press the motion, and regardless of what this committee does, I intend to press this issue and keep pressing it at every possible opportunity.
Okay. Thank you, Deputy. Okay. Nobody else?